We're joined via Skype by Dalia Fahmy. She's an Associate Professor of Political Science at Long Island University. Thanks for being with us. So the UAE denies that he's being prevented from travelling. What do you make of this story?
Well, it's interesting. He announces his candidacy for president this morning, and very short after there, he says that he's being detained or not allowed to leave for this tour of the diaspora communities all over the world for his candidacy. And so it means two things. Is his candidacy really being perceived as a threat by the regime itself? For example, besides winning the coming second place and winning the doing very well in the past election, he still enjoys a level of popularity amongst the Egyptian people. And so he could be perceived of, if he indeed does do an international tour, garnering more support that would lend itself to the Egyptian population, seeing that maybe there are alternatives. Now, the second interesting point is that because he has this great military career as a leader of the armed, the Air Force, it might be that he's running thinking that there is support within the Egyptian military. And if that is true, that there would be support, then he serves a threat to the current regime under President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, because he garners both popular support and a perception that he might have some military support.
How easy is it to tell, though, with in Egypt, whether someone like this would actually have popular support? I mean, would people be prepared to admit that they supported him?
Well, it's unclear that they would, because it's just the nature of Egypt today. But if there would be an election, and it's not even for certain that he would win. We know that President Sisi will win. But President Sisi today, because of the security situation, because of the recent terrorist attacks, needs to present himself as the commander of security and of the nation. And if there is this stirring for the coming election, where there could be a possible challenge among society, especially because of the economic conditions, especially because of the political conditions and the social conditions. And just today, there were supposed to be union elections within the universities, that this can be a moment where it's just too much too soon. And President Sisi and the regime, in collusion with the UAE, wants to avert any real competition.
And what do you make of the development that the UAE has denied that he's actually being prevented from traveling from there? How do you see it playing out next?
Well, we only have his version of the story. There is no official statement that he's not allowed to leave. However, it is not the first time that the UAE has played inside of the internal politics of Egypt. It happened in 2012 and during the 2013 coup. And so a bigger question that is not being asked is, why is it that the current administration in Egypt is allowing for an impinging on its sovereignty by a foreign actor, namely the UAE, if it is indeed holding an Egyptian citizen that did have such a high-ranking government position in the past?
Thank you very much indeed for joining us, Dalia Fahmy. Thank you.